Greetings, it's Shawana May. I'm feeling Omi, and I'm going to jump right into this. I keep getting booted off of YouTube. So I'm going to jump right into this. Today we're going to be doing the I for the middle name on the back side of the quilt. And I'm going to be doing it in yellow. We did the circle already in yellow. And now we're going to be doing the little sun rays. So let's get right into this. I made a pattern for the sun rays, which I went over in another video. So basically what you're going to do is cut 10 rectangles like this, and we're going to press them down like this, and then press them again, and that's how we get the sun rays, okay? This is the tip of the sun ray, this is the finished edge, and this is the open end, which is going to go under the circle all the way around, 10 of them all the way around, like you see back there. The open ends go underneath the circle, like that, underneath, and they'll get stitched down so that there's no raveling, okay? That's the goal. So, I've already cut 8 of these pieces. I'm going to show you how to cut them, and we're going to cut 2 more. And like I said, I had just enough leftover scrap fabric to cut these 10 out, so I'm really grateful. And that also meant I couldn't make any mistake. I might have enough for 3 more, so I could make 1 mistake. So I'm outlining this with my pen on the back side of the fabric. So that's the lighter side. This is the front, the more colorful side. I'm basically using the edges of the fabric as my corner piece. So all I have to do is trim around, line around 2 sides of the rectangle instead of drawing a whole rectangle. So I'm creating, and this already has the seam allowance, so you don't need to go out quarter of an inch. So we just need 2 more because I've already cut 8 for the sake of time. And I want to thank everyone for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so that you're notified when I do other videos. If you like my content, please share the videos with others. I'm trying to build up my subscriptions so that more people become familiar with my channel and I can get some sponsorship going, which would be great. I love to travel, I love nature, I love gardening, cooking, sewing. I have some other projects that will be of interest to you as I continue with this channel. I do yoga, really advocate for mental health. It's one of the reasons why I do art and yoga. I am an art therapy consultant. I do workshops. I've been sewing since I was a little girl. This is my first quilt. That's just a little bit about me. Okay, so now we have 10 of these. These 2 are a little bit bigger than the other ones, which is fine. And I got a couple of them that are kind of small too, which is fine. I think I might cut 1 more bigger one since I have enough to do that. 1 more that way. I got 2 that are really kind of small, and I don't know how those are going to turn out. But I used all the fabric that I had, so I couldn't make it any bigger. I, of course, had to make 10. Couldn't have done it with 8, because then there would have been a space missing, an open space. Couldn't have done it with 9. So now I have 11 pieces here. This one is really big. Really big shoe. Pardon me, I digress. I'm just going to trim a little bit of this off because that is really big. Okay. Okay, so now what we're going to do is start folding these under and making them into little triangles, okay? And then I'm going to take these letters. Well, I still have to finish my N. Your N is basically going to be like your A block letters, except it's going to be two parallel lines that go straight up and down. This is the N. The N is blue. I still have to press this down. So there are going to be two parallel lines that go straight up and down like this, with a slant line in between. And my slant line, I'm going to make a little thinner, like I made this in the center a little thinner. It just makes it look more aesthetically pleasing instead of ginormously large. Okay, so I'm going to set these aside so that I have some space over here to show you how to create these. Little points. And is my iron on? My iron's still on. Yes. I have this towel here to soak up the steam on my iron because it leaks. I love that iron, but I got it at the thrift store, and I know why whoever gave it to the thrift store gave it to the thrift store, because it leaks sometimes. So I have one, two, these separate, the larger ones, count three. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And I got two little tiny ones that I'm going to just kind of wait and see where they go and how they fit in. Okay, so right now you're just going to fold these back. So that's the front side of the fabric. You're going to fold them back to make a point like that. And then you're going to press them down like so. Do your best to make them meet in the middle and watch your fingers. Okay, so then there you go with that. See that? And then we're just going to fold them again in the center and press it one more time. Do your best to keep the edges equal, even. You want them even as you possibly can. You don't want one edge like this, or you don't want it above the other edge. You want them as even as you possibly can get them before you press them down. Okay, that is what's going to keep you from having extra work making these sunrays, where you'd have to cut them in a triangle with a seam allowance and then fold them and stitch them separately. That's a lot of work. Okay, so this is just an easier, this makes the sunrays a little bit thicker, so it's a little bit more 3D than just having a flat triangle. Say if I drew a triangle on here and then put a little tiny seam allowance around it and folded the edges that way. Somebody might choose to do it that way, but that just seems like a lot of work to me. So we need 10 of those. So if I had a high-speed camera, I'd be going really quick to get this done. The goal is for these to meet in the middle. And you also want to try and, if you can, this isn't quite as important to have the open ends, you know, even with the bottom of the open end, because you're going to stick all that fabric underneath the circle, but you also want to make sure you stick it underneath the circle deep enough to catch all of these edges, okay? So that's going to be the tricky part. So that could vary the size of your sunrays, how long they are, depending on how deep you tuck them under the circle, okay? So watch that as well. Be mindful. Okay, this one is, my edges are not even. I just want to make sure that they're even. And not all my edges on the red ones are even too. But get them as even as possible. It makes it a lot easier when you're sewing them down, believe me. That's going to be the challenging part, getting those all sewn down as evenly as possible. But that's what makes life fun, are its challenges, right? If everything was easy in life, we'd all be robots. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to be a robot. I want to stay human and make baby quilts instead of buying them on Amazon. Not that I have anything against Amazon. I love Amazon. I really do. But sometimes putting your personal touch into a gift makes all the difference in the world. I'm just going to try to keep these separated by size. And I'll probably end up putting the larger ones up here and the smaller ones towards the stem of the eye. The lowercase I. So right now, I'm just taking up your time because I don't have a Kamaku and I can't do a high speed version of this. I don't have a Kamaku yet. One day I'm going to have a Kamaku, you guys. I am. The other thing you can do when you're done doing all these is trim the open ends so that they're all even at the open end that you stick underneath. That way you know when you stick one side underneath that both sides are tucked under the circle, because that can be a little tricky trying to figure that out. And when you're doing that with 10 little rectangles, that can feel a little tedious. Every little extra bit of work could feel a little tedious. One thing this will do is teach you some patience, and the other thing is it's not as complicated as traditional quilting because I'm really creating my own kind of style of quilting right here. I'm not doing it like traditional quilt making, like how my grandmother and my great-grandmother did. I have some quilts I could show you guys that they made that are pretty cool. And then I've seen quilts that are even fancier than the ones that I have that were made by them. And the one that I'm using as the base for this one, I've seen, well, this is one that, the one that I'm making a base, it's one that they started that they never finished. And it, you know, aged over time. So it wasn't really a quilt that I could use without doing more damage to it. So I've done my best over the years to keep it preserved so that I could do something like this, like what I'm doing now. And if you are new, please subscribe to my channel and go back and watch this complete series so that you understand exactly what this blanket means. It has some sentimental value and why I am creating it, aside from it being a cool gift for my grandson. There's a reason why I did these letters and the colors that I did, okay, in the order that I did them. So these are all things that you can consider when you're creating your personal contemporary grandmother style patch quilt. And it doesn't have to be for a baby. You can do it for yourself. You can do it for someone's wedding. Put their, you know, their last name on the quilt. There doesn't have to be a name on the quilt. You can make it without a name. Okay. So, just whatever suits your fancy and whatever you feel would give you joy to do instead of being stressful. I'm making this as simple as possible so that I'm not stressing myself out to finish it. I think the main thing that's probably going to give me a little challenge is sewing these little triangles down. But, you know, I wanted to give myself a challenge so that I could feel as if I really invested some real effort into it. And that's just me because I'm an artist and I've created other things before this. And I sew. So I'm kind of pushing my... Almost got myself there. I'm kind of pushing myself to motivating myself by doing this design here, to push myself into actually making other types of quilts also, or making another quilt. My niece is having a baby. Thought about even making a quilt for her, for her baby as well. That's why it's not sticking down. So when you're pressing your letters, you definitely need a steam iron. This will not work if you don't have a steam iron. It'll be so frustrating if you don't have a steam iron. And even using a mister or spray bottle gets a little frustrating too. The fabric will get too wet and then it'll lose its shape before it dries. And see the difference that made? Just that bit of steam. Press that puppy down flat. Okay, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We need one more. I'm going to use this larger one here. Cut an extra one just in case I decide I want to, you know, I need a variation in sizes to my points. I might want to put a smaller point, two smaller points here where it meets the stem of the eye. Maybe, and then I might not, so that's why I decided to cut an extra one. And I had just enough fabric to cut an extra one. Okay, that was weird. That didn't go under the iron. That got stuck in the crack between the iron and the base of the, or the base of the iron and the white part of the iron. Okay, so now we got 10 and we got an extra piece. And we got the stem to the eye. I'm gonna press that down. Give it a little bit more stem. Okay. So this is how this is going to go. And like I said, if you want to, let's see, let me find one that you might want to do that on. Okay, here's a good one. You see, now this one is so little, I don't know if I want to do that, but this one has, underneath, the open end is not even all the way across. And I'm not going to cut that off because I'm going to, because this is one of my smaller sun rays. I might need that. Actually, I'm just going to trim a little bit. That way it'll have less of a chance of not catching the, of only catching the extra underneath and not catching the top, but it'll still, anyway. Trim it if you like, if you think you'll be able to work with it better. Here's a good one. This is a bigger one. That one has an uneven edge too, so you can trim them to where they're a little more even. Don't trim them too much because that'll make your rays smaller because you're going to tuck a portion of them underneath the circle. Okay, now this is just for demonstration sake, because when I pin them, I'm going to actually pin them on the actual fabric, okay? So this is how these are going to look. Hoping you can see that. See that? See that? And you're going to do that all the way around, making sure you get enough of the open end at the bottom of the point underneath the circle. And play with them, okay? Because this is not a straight, it's an angled triangle. It's not a straight up and down even-sided triangle. So the rays, you kind of want them all going in the same direction. So that's another thing you're going to need to play with. Okay, so we got three more here. You can always lift it up and look underneath and make you got, make sure you got enough under there. Okay. And also, if you want to pin them first, if that makes it easier for you to pin this before you pin it to the fabric, I just pin mine straight to the fabric. Okay. And I may actually end up taking this off and pinning it straight just to the circle, not on the fabric, so that I know that it's as perfect as possible before I apply it to the bottom or the base. Okay. So here you see that. Got 10 little sun rays. Isn't
Isn't that adorable?
Okay, so actually I would recommend you pinning these to the circle before you pin them to the fabric. I pretty much just did this so you guys could see what it looked like. I'm really kind of into instant gratification. That's one of the things with being a modern grandmother, right? The patience, the lack of patience thereof, perhaps even. I don't want to sew this. So that's gonna be it for now. Actually, let's pin these on here. Let's pin them on. Let's get them pinned. You wanna make sure the points are as even as possible. When you pin them, the sides, right, like I showed you, you don't want the sides, because when you sew that down, you won't catch both sides if they're not even. So you want the edges as even as possible. Pinning stuff can be a challenge. Okay.